Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Chemistry Unplugged. Today we will discuss about Wilkinson Catalyst. Wilkinson Catalyst is chloro-tris-triphenylphosphine rhodium. It is prepared by heating rhodium chloride RHCl3.H2O with excess of triphenylphosphine in boiling mixture of ethanol and benzene. It is very useful catalyst in various organic reactions. Here we are discussing its uses. First is decarbonylation of aldehyde. Decarbonylation word denotes D means removal and carbonyl. Removal of carbonyl group from aldehydes is decarbonylation. And we can use Wilkinson catalyst for this purpose. For example, this is a Wilkinson catalyst and it is in 16 electron state. 16 electron state means RH rhodium has 3D8 4S1 configuration, and in this complex it is in plus 1 state. So 8 electron in D shell and 8 electrons are provided by ligands. So total 16 electrons, and we know that according to 18 electron rule it try to complete its 18 electron. So when it react with an aldehyde it show oxidative addition. Oxidative addition means cleavage of a reactant, means cleavage of aldehyde in this reaction, and addition of its one or both part to the central metal atom of the complex, means when aldehyde breaks in two part. Okay, suppose H and RCO, and these two part either only RCO or both RCO and H will attach to the central metal atom, that is rhodium in this complex. So it is an oxidative addition, and in this process there is increase in the coordination number because we are attaching more ligands to the central metal atom, and increase in the oxidation state of the metal atom also. So in the oxidative addition, RCO and H will attach to the this complex and it will attain 18 electron state. The next step is dissociation, which causes removal of one ligand PPH3, and it again occupies 16 electron state. Then it undergo deinsertion and RCO will break to R and CO and it will occupy 18 electron state again. Then it will undergo reductive elimination. Reductive elimination is just opposite of oxidative addition. Means one or more part of the reactant will be removed from the complex. So the complex will be in the form of RH, PPH3, PPH3, ClCO. Because this complex has a strong affinity for carbon monoxide, so it will try to capture it and RH will be removed from the complex. So this process causes conversion of aldehyde into a alkane. Next uses formation of carbon-carbon bond. So in this reaction we are using Wilkinson catalyst and methyl lithium. So first step is ligand exchange. Cl will attach with the lithium and it will be removed as LiCl. And in next step we will use, suppose, phenyl iodide. It will undergo oxidative addition, means one or part, both parts in this reaction, both part pH as well as I will attach to the complex, and after this it will undergo reductive elimination. So CH3 and pH will be removed from the complex and there is formation of new carbon-carbon bond. Next and very important use of this catalyst is homogeneous catalytic hydrogenation of alkenes. We all are familiar with the heterogenetic catalytic hydrogenation of alkene, in which we are using palladium, platinum, but the most important And very stereoselective and specific reaction is homogeneous catalytic hydrogenation of alkenes using Wilkinson catalyst. Although the addition of hydrogen to the alkene to form alkane is a thermodynamically favored reaction, but it is very slow under the ordinary condition or room temperature. Therefore, we have to use heterogeneous and homogeneous catalyst for this reaction. So in this reaction, the first step is the Wilkinson catalyst will try to remove in the first step 1 pph3 group of the Wilkinson catalyst will be removed and it is exchanged by the solvent molecule. So the complex can attach with hydrogen atoms. Because the complex is very sterically hindered, it has 9 phenyl group. So you can imagine that it is how sterically hindered it is. So to attach hydrogen atom to the complex, we have to remove 1 or 2 pph3 groups from the complex. So in the first step, it is exchanged by solvent molecule. And in the next step, because now it is favorable to be attached with hydrogen, so in the next step, two hydrogen atoms will be attached and it will form a octahedral dihydro complex. In next step, we will use alkene to be hydrogenated. Okay, so it will attach to the complex and the solvent molecule will be removed. And in the next step is very fast, which involved the removal of alkene as well as syn addition of hydrogen atoms to it. You have to remember that it is syn addition. Syn addition generally leads to the formation of cis compounds. So if you are using alkynes, then cis alkene is preferentially formed. Then what are the benefits of using Wilkinson catalyst? It is very stereoselective and stereospecific, as well as when we have alkene, alkyne and COCN and NO2 groups together, then it can only attack C double bond C and C triple bond C. It will not reduce, it will not attack on COCN and NO2 group. For example, in this reaction, if we use Wilkinson catalyst, then it will reduce only CH double bond CH. Next benefit is it preferentially reduces mono and disubstituted double bonds to tri and or tetra substituted double bond. Means if we have double bonds which is mono substituted or disubstituted, it will be reduced in preference to tri or tetra substituted double bonds. For example, in this molecule we have two types of double bond. This double bond is mono substituted and this double bond is tri substituted. So if we use Wilkinson catalyst, then it will reduce only this double bond. Cis alkenes are reduced rapidly than trans alkenes. Isolated double bonds are reduced rapidly than conjugated double bonds. For example, in this reaction, in this molecule, we have two types of double bond. These two double bonds are in conjugation, but this double bond is isolated. So, Wilkinson catalyst will reduce only this double bond. Next is, terminal alkynes are rapidly hydrogenated than terminal alkenes. In this molecule, we have terminal alkene as well as terminal alkyne, but terminal alkyne will be reduced in preference to terminal alkene. So the right size of alkene is required to be hydrogenated easily by the Wilkinson catalyst, because Wilkinson catalyst is very sterically crowded or hindered molecule. Therefore, big size alkene or the complex alkene cannot easily coordinate with the metal complex. So simple alkenes or right size alkene which can easily attach with the complex can be reduced easily. So here we have a preference order of the alkenes can be hydrogenated by Wilkinson catalyst. So, alkenes with monosubstituents hydrogenated in preference to cyclohexene. Then, disubstituted cis alkene, then trans alkene, then tri-substituted alkene, and last is the tetra-substituted alkene, which cannot be easily hydrogenated by using Wilkinson catalyst. Wilkinson catalyst is not chiral in nature, but can be converted into chiral catalyst by replacing its triphenylphosphine groups with chiral phosphine. So, suitable chiral ligand can lead to enantioselective hydrogenation. Enantioselective hydrogenation means we want to generate a enantiometrically favored so that it can produce a particular chiral product. But the alkenes to be hydrogenated must be prochiral. Prochiral means it must have a structure that lead to R or S chirality. So, the Wilkinson catalyst has the capability of converting optically inactive prochiral alkene into optically active product. So, it is known as asymmetric induction or enantioselective synthesis. So, here we have a rhodium 1 complex in which NMDPP is neomethyl diphenylphosphine, and if we use it to hydrogenate E-beta methyl cinnamic acid, it will give 61% enantiotropic excess of this product. This example is rhodium complex containing chiral diphosphine DIOP. RHDIOPCl2. This is the structure of RHDIOPCl2, and when we use it to hydrogenate this alkene, it will convert it into S-DOPA, and it is used as a medicine for the treatment of Parkinson's disease. So, this Wilkinson catalyst can be converted into an enantioselective catalyst for the conversion of alkenes into a particular type of particular chiral molecule. Then, Wilkinson catalyst does not cause hydrogenolysis. What is hydrogenolysis? Hydrogenolysis is cleavage of carbon heteroatom bond, and then it's catalytic hydrogenation. Aliphatic alcohols are generally inert for this reaction, but aromatic compounds show this reaction. For example, we have benzyl alcohol here, and if we use hydrogen palladium for its reduction, then it will break this carbon oxygen bond and then hydrogenate this into CH3. So we have toluene. So this reaction is known as hydrogenolysis. In the next example, again we are using hydrogen palladium. It will break this CHCl bond and then hydrogenate it. In next example, we are using first Wilkinson catalyst. So, Wilkinson catalyst will not break this oxygen-carbon bond and will only reduce this double bond. And next we are using hydrogen palladium. It will break this bond and then reduce this double bond as well as reduce this CH2. But if we have CHO group as well as double bond, then Wilkinson catalyst will remove carbon monoxide. It will do decarbonylation in preference to hydrogenation because it has a strong affinity for carbon monoxide. So that's it. I will end today's my video here. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please share my videos and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for future notification. Thank you.